My name is Christine Mwilu Mutuku. I come from Fuwandani, in the former informal settlements, and I belong to Federation Muungano in Kenya. I'm one among the people who are doing data collection. We did data collection in Mukuru, Kajafan. We reached eight villages, and in those eight villages, before we started taking the data collection, we offered training to the community members, whereby we told them how to collect the data, how to talk with the community people, and we also talked with the authority, that is the chief in that area, and he gave us permission as Muungano Federation members, and we took the data. Then from the training, we went to the field, whereby we are taking the structures. We wanted to know how many structures are in that area, how many people live in that area, what kind of services are offered in that area. We are taking GPS, that is water kiosk, where there is a toilet, where there is sewer line, where there is a power line. What kind of electricity these people are using? Are they using the legal electricity or the illegal electricity? This is the kind of information we are trying to collect in that ground. And those people were so interested. They wanted to know, why is Muungano people operating in their area? Are they planning to destroy their structures? Are they planning those people to be chased from that area? But we gave them a good information that Muungano or Wanavijiji is there to stand with them, to take their information to the county government, to know the people who are living in that place, so that we can have a good communication with our government. We met with the different kinds of people. What type of people? They are learned people, and they are those who are not learned people. And there are people who are somehow stable, and others who are not stable. Others in schools, and others not in schools. Some with small businesses, others who are looking for jobs. What we found in that data is those people are so many living in a small place. And the structures that people are using, they are very dangerous because it is made of iron sheet and wood. And they live in a risky area because fire can come anytime and their properties are destroyed and they are not paying by anyone. Some of the challenges that we found in that area is those people, they are living in land which has no title deed. And that is why their life is in a risk. Because at any time they can be sent away, they have nowhere to go. That was one big challenge. Another challenge is the services that they have in that place. There is no enough toilets, no water. They use a sugu for short call and long call. They share one room, a full family in that one room. And it is really stressful. You know, a mother, a father, children, and if a relative or if a friend comes, they are just using that one house. It was a big challenge. Even those people to have money to educate their children, it was a really big challenge because they are not able, they are not stable financially, they are not even able to get enough food for their stomach, even the clothing, they are not able to maintain good standard of wearing. They are sometimes they are supported by Good Samaritan, by NGOs, of which it is a big challenge. Some of the challenges as we are collecting the data, we ourselves data collectors, is we encountered many people are so drunkard in that area. They don't want to respond to our questions. When you try to ask them questions, they don't want to answer. They think that we are coming with a bad motive. Okay, in that area, to be sick is very easy because of sewer lines are so open. Everything is so dirty in that place. Even to eat the food in that place, it is a big challenge. For us to overcome the challenge, it was for us to take everything easy, so that we can come to the standard of these people. We also come from the slums, and we came to their standard. We told them there is a better future if you can start groups and start saving. Then after the savings, after a long term of saving, you can get your money, you can buy a land somewhere, you can do something to change your life. Although it was so challenging, we really took time and we reached those people with a good information. after saving, you will live a better life. Those people are so interested to know more about Muungano. They saw people who love them and people who want to take care of them. So it is good when we are provided with the best services, we will reach those people, we will try to maintain those groups. We will bring men to Muungano, and men will learn more and more better things from Muungano. Muungano is something that has changed lives of men.